What's up, everybody? Once again, it's Brand Man Sean, and this video is brought to you by BrandManNetwork.com because I signed myself. Now, I gotta say, this video is not legal advice. Just gotta make that clear. All right, so ownership. That's something that so many artists are privy to. They really love the idea of ownership, and that's been great. But we talk about it from the standpoint of like your masters and, you know, your company and all those kind of things. But one of the things that's traditionally been so important to artists is owning their ideas. You know, those things where you come up with a cool concept and then you see somebody else trying to do it and you want to make sure you're getting your credit. Well, it is my firm belief that legal ownership is not the final ownership and maybe not even the most important ownership. Let me explain. Well, let's take Kanye West for an example. A few years ago, you know, a lot of people could remember that he did the floating stage. And when he did his floating stage, people thought it was this extremely dope concept. Oh man, never seen anything like this before. And then after that, it started to come out that there was a South African artist by the name of Casper who actually did a floating stage as well. But before that, it was a smaller scale, right? But it was a floating stage, you know, nonetheless. Kanye just took that, did it on a bigger scale like so many other things he does, right? He sees them and then he maxes them out in one way or another. Let's just say that there was a way that the guy could legally own that concept. I'm not sure if it could be, but let's just say it was a way he could legally own that concept. And let's say he was an American artist and he did it, but then Kanye did it on a far bigger scale. And then what happened was Kanye's a way bigger artist and people found this concept through Kanye. And after people find out through Kanye, then just like happened in real life, there's a lot of people that find out that there's other artists that did this too. And some people are like, yo, man, you stealing, you copping, you didn't give anybody credit, you're supposed to be this super artist dude, but you're taking ideas from other artists. Well, that's cool, right? That's the series of events. But at the end of the day, you gotta think about the fact that most of the public, for one, doesn't even find out that Kanye took this idea or allegedly took this idea from another artist. So one, most of those people believe Kanye owns that concept, right? He invented that concept in their mind. He introduced that concept in their mind. And even after that, after people find out that he took it, some people will be upset. You know, you're going to have that small fan base that say, you know what, man, he's wrong. He took this from these other people. But a lot of people who find out, they're still going to think about Kanye first. They're going to credit him mentally just because that's the way the mind works. So the ultimate ownership is the ownership in people's minds, because that real estate, right, no matter what you can do from a legal structure, will not change. So it may be encouraging if you can't afford legal bills, but it might be discouraging if you're like, yo, somebody else might take my idea and put it in front of other people before me. Yeah, there's a pro and a con to it. There's both sides to it. But at the end of the day, the greatest ownership is the ownership within people's minds, because that is the hardest thing to move once they're presented with something. They're angered towards that energy, that opinion. And at the end of the day, even if they can acknowledge you for doing it, particularly acknowledging you for doing it first before this other person, it's still diluted. Your impact is diluted in a lot of ways because I was still introduced from somebody else, and the way that other person did it still awed me. It gave me this feeling of, yo, this is amazing. Who even thought of this? And now that I found out who thought about it, and then I even see your version of it, and I'm like, I kind of like that other version better. And that's why I'm so passionate about marketing brand, because at the end of the day, if you don't know how to get to people, and then if you don't know how to, you know, give them your message, give them the thing that you want them to have to stick with them, then, you know, you're playing a losing game. Yes, from a legal standpoint, somebody might have the money, of course. And that's one thing that's obviously important, right? I'm not one of those people that say, hey, let's get well known and then not be collecting the money, because that's a very real situation. Even if you look at Juice WRLD having that song that popped off, I can't remember the name right now, but you know, he's paying Sting 95% of the royalties on that song. That's wild. However, this perspective is so important as well, because especially for artists, right? People who care about their work, people who are creative and spend time, you know, just going through and fleshing out ideas, you want ownership of the idea. You want credit as well. That's one of the most important things to artists, because in this creative space, right, that's the only real ownership there is. So if that is the ultimate ownership for a creative, then you have to figure out how you actually make that happen, how you actually get that thing packaged and branded and known by the right people. So then you can get that credit. And I'm not saying don't do the legal stuff. I'm not saying that at all. But remember that just getting your copyrights is not enough, right? Just getting your trademark is not enough. If you really want to truly own a concept, then you have to make sure you get it into people's minds as well. That's it. This video is brought to you by BrandManNetwork.com. If you like this video, go ahead and like button. If you like it, you might as well share it. If you're not subscribed, you know what to do. Hit that subscribe button.